Okay, so this is a quick overview of a main stage set. This main stage set has 15 songs in it and a template pre-song just to load other songs in. Just want to go over a few things. When main stage has this many tracks in it and what they call playback plugins, it takes a while for 15 songs, because you figure 15 times 8 tracks is quite a few stems to load up in individual plugins. So it takes a while for it to open. So when you first click on your main stage set that I send you, you're going to get this little loading apparatus there, and then it'll get stuck on a song. It'll look like the thing is stuck, and this could take anywhere to, depending on how fast your computer is and how many times you've opened this set, could take anywhere between like 5 to even 10 minutes to open it up. But then after it opens up, it works fine. It's just loading each individual stem into each individual plugin. So it takes a long time. So don't get frustrated. Just after it hits this screen, just walk away and come back when it opens. And that's about the best you can do using Mainstage. That's why it's better to use Ableton. But Mainstage works great after it's open. It'll work fine. So just let this sit here and build for a while, and then I'm going to shut my recorder off, and I will come back when this is opened. Okay, so I'm back. It took exactly 5 minutes for it to open with 15 songs. Let me explain to you the reason why. So each song, there's a little plugin over here in your tracks, and that plugin's called it's called Playback. And so for each song, they're using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and then with the clicks, 10. So you're using 10 playback engines. So you have basically 15 songs in this set, and times 15. So it's got to load each individual stem individually. And what this right here, this template one, is, so if you're going to load your own songs, what you would do is you'd basically click on this template. It's blank, so there's nothing in these playbacks in on the template. And you don't really want to mess with that. What you want to do is just hit, or just duplicate it, Command-D on a Mac, and it'd duplicate it. And then you can name, and then use that one, name it, you know, new song. And then you can load your stems. There's a lot of different tutorials on YouTube. You have to watch tutorials on this. But basically, after you do about 4 songs in a group, there's this little group down here. You need to change the group. So you can do about 4 songs in group. Right now there's, you know, group 3. So what you'd do is, if you're going to add another song, you'd change this to group 4, and you have to do that to every playback in that song. So you know, do that first and then add another song. But basically, you got to click on each playback in the new song, change to group 4, go to the next one, click on that, change to group 4, next one, click on that, so on and so forth, change to group 4. And then you just drag your MP3s or waves just right on top of here, and it'll go in there. These will move around. So you know, when you're putting in songs, you know, you'll have this to, you know, play with, or you can go to performance mode and it'll look like this, and then you can actually trigger these to MIDI controllers, and this will actually bring your patches up or down. So you can go to, you know, up or down, and you know, and then here, play button, stop, return, you know. You don't really need to worry about this stuff over here because you're not using it. But, you know, so to start a song, I'd click on a song, hit play, and you can patch that to another song. I have my headphones in, but let's see if you can hear this. Anyhow. So, I don't know if you can hear that or not. I'm doing this through my two headphones, but... Anyhow, so let me go back and just show you how to set up your set when you get it. It's pretty much ready to go. Just, you know, click play. The only thing you need to do is you go over here to edit window, and you can pull this back and forth. You can get to your tracks, and you'll see your you have your master slider here, and your master click here and your main out here. So this will be where your music goes out, and this will be what your click track comes out of. So you have your click track and your cue track. So that's the volume for it. Now, just real quick, each time you go to a song, if you're like Earth, Wind & Fire, right, and you come over here and you want to get a mix, so you go through here and you can, you know, mix from this window, but you know, if you mix it from this window, just get it in where you want it. Say, with, you know, if you're using drums, you want the drums here, you know, bass, whatever, and you get the mix, you're playing along with it, and you like that, then go up and go save, and you'll save that mix for that song. So if I see, look at this mixture happening here, I'll put the drums way up here, just, you know. So if I put the mixer here right now and I click on the next one, you'll see that the mix changed. So the mix will change for each song. So, but if I didn't save it, like I didn't save it, I just moved that drum up further, I click back on here, you'll notice the drum didn't go up. If I go all the way up here and I click save, it would save that where that's at. But if I move it and I click the next song, it will not save this. So you need to move it, get your mix you want, go to file, save, and then click on the next song, and it'll do that. I'm not going to save it right now just because this is your set. The next thing you want to do is, if you go up here to main stage and you go to preferences and you want to go to audio, this is where you're going to select your sound card. Right now I'm using the built-in, so it's basically just stereo. To do this right, you want a sound card with at least, you know, 4 outs. So, you know, I can email you some good 4-out sound cards, or, you know, you can get for $60 used, which is Behringer with some Myers preamps in it. So what you'd do is you'd basically go here to audio, you'd go to the output, you'd pull down and you would see your new sound card there, your USB sound card, and that's what you would select, and that would give you 4 outs. And then you can also have the input too, but you're not really using the input, so you just want to select. Right now I'm using built-in, so it's the only option I have. If I had the other sound card, you'd see it there, it'd say USB something, I would select that, and then you click on setup and it'd tell you, you know, how many ins and outs if you wanted to. But then what you do is you go back over here and go on. You have to go to each track, I believe. Let's see. You have to go to pretty much each track, I believe, but maybe not. I don't have another sound card yet, but you'd probably have to be. You go over here to click, and you don't need to worry about these. These are going to bus one, and this is your master click. So all you have to do is change this bus one right here to where it says main out. You don't want it to go out main out because that'll bring out your main. So what you want to do is click on this right here. There you go. And go to output, and then you'll see when you have 4 outputs, you'll see your main outputs. You know, it's 1 and 2. And then you go to 3 and 4, and that'll be your headphones for your drummer or whatever like that. And so that's how you get that to go out. If you're just using your internal sound card, then basically what you got to do is just you'll pan this. Wait, hold on. You'll pan this right here all the way to one side, and your main all the way to the other side. So now when you plug in, you'll have if you have headphones on, your click will be in one ear, the music will be in the other ear. And if you run out to a mixing board, you have a split Y cable, and you'll the side of the Y that has the music coming out, you'll run this to the sound, front of house sound, and this to your drummer or whoever needs a click. But I wouldn't really recommend doing that. I would just get a sound card with 4 outs and do it, so you could run this music coming out stereo and have your click. So that's how you set up your click. And so your click's on one side and your music's on the other. Or if you have a 4-out sound card, you can run stereo to the outboard and have a whole other mix coming through your headphones. And that's pretty much it. All you do is you can either play it in this mode, and like I said, you mix here and save each time you mix, and that way, even if you mute, so if I, you know, say if you're on live, you don't want to have drums, so you mute that, and then save it, and that'll stay muted next time you come back, next time you go to play it. And so you can either leave it like this and do it, but if you're performing, you already have everything set up and mixed the way you want, click on performance mode, and that'll bring it up like this. And then you can, if you have a MIDI controller, you can MIDI map this stuff. So, or you can go up and down on the up down arrows on your, that's what I'm doing right now, on your Mac. Then I'll take you through your songs, or you can MIDI map these right here. There's tutorials online to show you how to do that, or I'll make a tutorial later on. You can MIDI map these for up and down on your keyboard or whatever, and that'll take you through up and down the songs, or even a foot switch. You have a MIDI foot switch. You can control this from your foot. And then, so if you have, say, a three-button MIDI control foot switch, it's USB, like the Line 6 pedal boards, for their USB pedal boards work great. You can actually MIDI map, a button for up and a button for down and a button for play and a button for stop. And so you can do that all from your foot. But now if I click on a song, unplug these, hit a click, come in.
Intro, 2, 3, 4.
Now when you're in this mode, the only mix you'll have, I don't have the click or the cue on this mixer. You have to go back to the other mixer for that.
Chorus, 2, 3, 4.
You can mute anything you want. So you can mute anything, you can solo something, you can turn the volumes up and down.
Tag, 2, 3, 4.
All in this mode. But if you want to adjust your clicks, you'd need to do that over on the edit window, which is here. Anyhow, hope that helps out.